Hey guys, it's the Boga Johnny, and today I'm doing the much anticipated sequel to the first episode of Pixels and Kittens, the one about a cheese wedge. And though I thought it wasn't very popular, apparently you guys want more, and I'll be happy to make more. These scripted shows can be a lot of fun to make. Anyways, today we're doing Donkey Kong. Just so you know, I'm going to be doing a recording of me playing Donkey Kong in the background, and that's probably how these will work from now on. So anyways, let's get started. So one good hard choice in this game is how it's very simplistic. You can tell that DK is bad, and that you want to save Pauline because the damsel in distress is in distress, and our big gorilla is right there by her. You know that almost everything, like the fire and barrels, are deadly. And also, Mario spins for a while when he dies, so that you know he's he dead. I'm not saying all games should go back to being 8-bit or something, but we shouldn't have to have trial and error just to find the goal of a game. Another thing is that you can easily tell that the hammers are good. I don't quite understand why it's like this, but it may be caused by them not moving and being in the air. But I knew almost immediately that they were good, so that's a thumbs up. What I think was the best art decision, however, is how everything points upward, getting you to go in that direction. The floors point up, the ladders go up, and there seems to be something at the top. It's a gorilla. This helps explain the game and encourages you to go up, and that is necessary because there wasn't a manual for you to read. There wasn't the internet to get cheat codes from. You needed the game to explain itself, and Donkey Kong does this very well. And that may have made the difference between the game sinking and swimming. So remember, next time you play Mario or Donkey Kong Country, that if this game hadn't pointed the way for players, those games may not have existed. This has been the Poke Johnny, and thank you for watching the latest episode of Pixel and Kittens.